Hallo iedereen, welkom bij Dutch & Go. Today we're going to talk about what it is that makes a language difficult. And I'll be specifically giving you some examples with regards to Dutch. Let's go. I've basically developed four criteria that we can use to determine whether a language is difficult or not. And what, how that will impact basically the difficulty of a language. So the first criteria is transparency. By that I mean, how easy is it to understand a rule and how easy is it to apply the rule to other situations, to new verbs, to new situations, basically. So some very good examples of things that are untransparent in Dutch are things like de or het. It's really not transparent and there's no way to know whether a word is with de or with het, except for some categories, but in general, no. The forms of the past tense in Dutch are highly irregular, whether in participium or imperfectum. Why is it denken, dacht, gedacht? Komen, kwam, gekomen. Zeggen, zij, gezegd. No idea. You just have to learn these highly irregular forms, and there are quite a lot of them too. Also, for example, prepositions. Prepositions is quite a difficult one because prepositions can be quite difficult to translate, especially when they become more figurative. So here I'm not talking about prepositions that would describe positions or situate time. No, I'm talking about prepositions that would be used in expressions or in combinations with verbs. So for example, denken aan. Why is that aan and not another verb, another preposition rather, like it is for example in English, it's to think about, and why is it denken aan? No clue, that's just how it is. So which prepositions use in combination with which verb or expression is not always very transparent or easy to understand. However, quite transparent in Dutch are things like verb conjugations in the present tense. Most verbs are conjugated according to one rule and one rule only, so that's super, super easy. Or the plural of nouns. Most of the times it's en, sometimes it's s, but there's actually quite a lot of like transparency. Once you know the basic rules, you can do most of the plural nouns in Dutch. Same goes for lang and kort. Once you understand how to pronounce each variation of the vowel, it's quite easy to understand how to say it based on how it's written, and it's also quite easy to write it based on how it's pronounced. So here I'm not talking about the actual physical pronunciation of the long, short vowels, but rather the correspondence between the way that it's written and the way that it's pronounced. Very transparent. Or also things like inversion or eindgroep, things related to the structure, is quite transparent. Once you know the rule, you can apply it, and there are literally not a lot of exceptions, and it would most of the time be correct. So those rules are quite transparent. Then, the second category is the impact that grammar would have, and that these rules would have, on you being understood, or on you understanding other people. Let's first talk about the things that don't have that high of an impact. And this is a little bit of a, let's say, teacher's secret, because I think not all of the teachers explain this to their students, but I think it's important, especially if you don't have to do an exam, if you're not studying Dutch to do an exam, it is important to know which grammatical elements will have a high impact on you being understood or understanding other people, and which ones won't, because then basically you can also focus your attention a lot better on the things that really, really matter. So things like inversion or even eindgroep, I'm not just talking really about applying the structure consistently. Yeah, sure, it's important to know, but ultimately it won't impact you being understood all that much. Whether you apply inversion or not, it doesn't really give you a whole different meaning to the sentence. The same goes for de or het, even though there's a huge amount of focus and a huge amount of videos about de or het, ultimately the impact on the language, on you being understood correctly, is also quite minimal, because basically there are not a lot of words in Dutch that exist both with de and het, and that would have radically different meanings. That's just not the case. So ultimately, in the grander scheme of things, if you do the maths, 70% of the times it's de, if you're unsure, use de. 70% chance that you're going to get it right. And ultimately, it doesn't matter all that much, kind of thing. Then things that would have a high impact on you being understood are things like the past tense, of course, because if I were to use a form incorrectly or mix up forms or whatever, if I say kocht, but rather I meant kookte, that would be a highly different meaning. Then things like lang, kort has a huge impact on you being understood. If you use lang or kort inconsistently, then that could result in major communication problems and strong accents as well. So yeah, those things I would absolutely focus on trying to get right. And then there are sort of in-between cases such as the prepositions, which, sure, sometimes, depending on the situation, can have a high impact or low impact. That depends a bit. Of course, the more figurative you go, when you combine them in combinations with verbs, people will expect a certain preposition, and if you use the wrong one, people might find it more difficult to understand you. But I would say that this very much depends on the context and the situation. So, sort of in between. Category number three, which is the frequency. So how often do these grammatical rules, these untransparent or transparent situations appear? So for example, when it comes to the perfectum and imperfectum, sure, it's highly irregular, highly untransparent, and hugely impactful on you being understood, sure. But then on the other hand, they also appear super often. So they appear in articles, texts, books, music, in conversations. So basically that also means that you have lots and lots and lots of opportunities to basically practice them, get in touch with them, and repeat them and review them. However, then in comparison to that, prepositions, certain prepositions and certain expressions with prepositions can be highly irregular, can have a high impact on you being understood, and then can be also highly infrequently used and rarely used. So that means that for the 1 or 2% of the times that you actually need it, you have to get it right if you want to communicate clearly. So in that case, I would say that that adds another level of difficulty if it's highly irregular, high impact, and it doesn't appear very frequently, so you can't practice it all that often. Category number four are a group of factors that I call personal factors. So here the list is quite extensive, and I've picked out five elements that would basically consist of this category, but I'm sure there are other ones that I'm not discussing now. But basically things like learning disabilities. If you have a learning disability, it's of course going to make it a lot more difficult to study a language. If you have other languages that you speak, and if you are able to use the knowledge that you have of those other languages into your new language, into your target language that you're learning easily, then of course Dutch might be, well, quite easy if you already speak Dutch, if you already speak, sorry, English, French, or German, and you're able to use the knowledge of these other languages, the things that you know about these other languages, then yeah, Dutch can be quite easy. However, if you find it quite difficult to compare these languages, then that is not going to make Dutch any easier necessarily. So that depends a little bit on your other languages and your ability to compare them. Then there's also things like speech impairments. If you have any impairments, might impact on you being understood well, or you being able to make certain vowels or consonants correctly. And that will also, of course, very much depend on your mother tongue, exposure to other languages as a kid, and things like that. Depending on your mother tongue, you might have serious problems distinguishing between certain vowels or certain consonants, pronouncing them correctly, etc., etc. Then there's also the factor of the contact with the language. So how often do you have contact with the language? Do you watch a lot of movies, series, programs? Do you listen to music? What is it exactly that you do to get in touch with Dutch? Are you enjoying yourself as you do that? How are your Dutch classes and things like that? So what is your contact with the language? What is your exposure to the language? That will also hugely influence on how easy it will be for you to learn Dutch. And then finally is your personal relationship with the language. So is your personal relationship with the language positive or not? Are you learning it because you want to learn it, because you're interested in the culture, in society, politics, whatever? Are you studying it because you have to? Do you not have any other choice, but do you have to? And are you not really interested in the things that you're watching or listening to in Dutch or reading for that matter, and you're a little bit frustrated? All of that, of course, is going to have a huge impact on how easy or on how difficult you perceive this language to be. Of course, this is going to be a lot more in the subjective realm of things, but of course, as we all know, mentality is really 50% of the work, and coming at it with a positive mentality is just going to make this whole process of learning a new language a lot easier. So there you go. These are my four categories basically what it is that makes a language difficult. So just to recap, there's transparency, there's the impact that the rules have on understanding, you understanding other people or being understood yourself. There's the frequency of certain grammatical elements, and there are a bunch of personal factors and reasons that we can also analyze and try to understand. So basically, I would love to hear from you in the comment box. What do you think that I've left out? What have I forgotten? What have I not mentioned yet? Do you agree with my analysis? Do you have any amendments or anything that you would like to point out to me? And what is your experience with learning Dutch? I would love to hear from you, because I really think it's important that to go beyond just, oh yeah, Dutch is a difficult language. Personally, to sum up, I don't think Dutch is so difficult for beginners. It's quite easy to get started. The structure is quite transparent. The verb conjugation in the present tense is quite transparent. For beginners, I think it's not that difficult in comparison to maybe some other languages. For example, maybe you've never thought about that, but like, let's look at English, where the pronunciation and the way that you spell it is hugely untransparent. It's really, really not clear. And someone who's never had contact really with Dutch, with English rather, might find that very difficult. So that's something, you know, to think about. But I think that Dutch for beginners can be quite easy. But please, I would love to hear from you what you think. Thank you so much for watching. Dit was Dutch & Go. Tot de volgende keer en nog een fijne dag. Dag!